Hello, planet Earth.
Mind if I come in?
Welcome to my YouTube channel, we're at IDK, my BFF Jill 730. I'm Preston L. Young, wishing you warm salutations and congratulations as always. You've made your way to the Buffyngton Post.
Darling, take a look around, there's a lot to see.
Today it's time for another Buffyngton Post recap and review, and so I'd like to invite you all to put on your Giles glasses and grab your preferred copy of Giles Season 11, Issue Number 4, it's Girl Blue, Part 4. We've got two covers this month. I really like the one by, I'm assuming it's Stephen Morris. I'm not going to look at it. It looks very much Stephen Morris-y. It's very nifty. It's got Giles. He's putting Roux in this, like, magical spell because he's going to have to stake her. It's really lovely. I like her facial expression. She looks very betrayed by Giles and angry. And he looks really forlorn about having to do this to her. And so it's really lovely. Like, I really like the facial expressions in particular. And we also see that there'll be an eclipse in the issue, which the cover is very nice. And then we've got this, like, Buffy the High School Years cover. It's very, like, teen angst with Giles and Roux, and he feels, like, bad, like, oh, I'm in love with a vampire, blah, blah, blah. It's fine. But before we get into this planet Earth...
Previously on Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
While the government is, like, rounding up all of the magical folk, the Scoobies decided to hide Giles away, but while they were hiding him away, they wanted him to do some reconnaissance investigation into this charter school called Living Legend Charter School, okay? So at the school, there's, like, been these disappearances and deaths, and he's supposed to get to the bottom of it. There was this one teacher who died, and there was a student who went missing, and then there was another teacher who, like, went missing or died or something. It's kind of, like, irrelevant, whatever. So while at the school, he meets this girl who turned out to be a vampire, and now we find out that Roux, the vampire in question, she actually is not, like, a regular vampire, she's, like, a cool vampire. And so, she was a slave back in the early 1800s, and she was sired by this vampire who, like, protected slaves, etc. So when he made her into a vampire, he bound these two slaves to her somehow. It's really not explained how. And, basically, she is not, like, a regular vampire. She has these, like, glowing tattoos. Like, well, they're not really tattoos. They're these glowing names that appear on her. They're, like, people that she feels regrets about. And her hair turned into this, like, glowing blue shit. Whatever. And so it turned out that the problem that's going on in the school is related to this demon called Seed that Giles had actually banished decades ago before he even met Buffy. And so obviously, like, before he died and got resurrected as a teenager because, oh yeah, FYI, Giles is, like, max 15 years old now, okay? So Giles and Roux kind of put aside their differences, him being a watcher and her being this, like, not quite a regular vampire, whatever that means, so that they could get to the bottom of the situation because she is trying to protect this young girl called Blue while he's getting to the bottom of the Seed situation. Now, Seed was building this brain drain machine so that he could suck out the intelligence from people so that basically they could weaponize ignorance. They could make everybody super dumb so that they could take advantage of the circumstances around them. And Seed had built this prototype that he was using on the school to kind of, like, show his investors how well it worked and that it was gonna be great for everybody involved, okay? So it looked like they got rid of Seed and his, like, dumbifying, like, dumb ray, okay? Yeah, but, like, you know, the thing with demons, unless you actually, like, super get rid of them, they're always gonna come back and stuff like this. So Seed is, like, still a problem, and we're still, like, dealing with the mystery, because at the end of the last issue, after Roux had, like, spilled the beans of her whole story, turns out that she had a flask, from one of the teachers, and so, like, things are clearly, like, not on the up and up with Roux. Also, there was this character called Mrs. Vega who doesn't fucking matter. Also, we're supposed to believe this whole time that Giles and Roux are falling in love.
That's pretty much what you need to know, and so without further ado, let's jump into Giles, Season 11, Issue Number 4. It's the finale, Girl Blue, Part 4. Here we go.
You ready?
Rupert. Rupert. Rupert.
Along with me.
Rupert.
So we pick up with Giles after he has sneaked out of Roux's house, apartment, whatever she lives in, and he is kind of ruminating on his life and how he actually likes being in high school because everybody's still learning and being able to, like, create themselves from scratch is just what Giles is trying to do in the first place, and he's thinking about, like, how he is himself. Like, he spent so much of his life, like, looking at himself but not really seeing himself, and now he has this opportunity as he's kind of growing into, another version of himself to really kind of look and see what kind of man he wants to be. And then we pick up with him and Addison down in the sinkhole where Seed was doing his whole business, and Seed, is still, like, a problem. And so, basically, Addison is super-duper smart, he's a mathematician and all this good stuff, and Giles thinks that he and Addison can actually, like, reverse-engineer Seed's plan, okay? Like, the machine situation. So then it turns out that Addison is still, like, super-possessed by Seed, and so Giles can't be working with him because he can't let Seed know what he's up to because, you know, problems and demons. We gotta get rid of the demons. So Giles uses this spell to, like, electrocute Alistair, or Addison rather, so that he can, like, get him out of the picture, get him out of the way, and work on the problem himself. So as Addison is being taken away by the paramedics, he tells Rupert that Seed's plan that he's, like, mentally connected to has something to do with getting his machine, not the prototype that they destroyed, but the actual machine that he's been working on. Seed has to get to a very high place, and Giles surmises that it must be, like, the top of the bridge, like we saw at the beginning of issue number one, which was a flash forward. Okay, so Giles gets on the horn with Willow, who, by the way, is still in the not an internment camp that's totally just a safe zone for magical folks, and he's telling her about Seed and the plan and the dumb ray majigger that he's built, and also about Roux, and Willow says that, well, there's going to be an eclipse tonight, and that will amplify Seed's powers as well as the power of this dumb ray machine that he's created. And it'll also amplify your own magical abilities so that you will probably be on par with Seed enough to actually fight him off. And she basically tells him, this Roux girl, she's a vampire. You might not be able to trust her, and you have to know that if push comes to shove, you're gonna have to actually kill her, okay? Well, then, of course, Roux has been listening to all of this. She's been spying on Giles the whole time. So in the last issue, Truman alluded to the fact that Blue had killed somebody, and so we go into this flashback and we see it from Roux's perspective, and because of the dumb ray, like the dumbrella that Seed has kind of put around the school at that point in time, Blue was in like retract or detention or whatever. And she was kind of, like, super confused and angry and anxious, and because she wasn't in control of her faculties, she grabbed this great big book and she smacked the teacher over the head with it. But Truman thought that she had killed him, but she hadn't actually killed him. So Truman runs off to go and tell somebody that Blue had killed this teacher, even though he had no reason to believe that he was actually dead because of a school book hitting him over the head. But anyway, so Roux drops down from the ceiling. She's like, hey girl, I'm gonna take care of this, but I need you to run away. So Roux was going to totally, like, take care of Truman to protect Blue, but before she got the chance, Seed grabbed him up, okay? And so Roux went flying off, and then he's like, okay, well, what about Ms. Wong? What the heck happened to her? So it turned out that basically, Ms. Wong, she was just super sad and depressed, and she hanged herself, and Roux just didn't stop her. So Roux, being a vampire, is not affected by the Dumbrella, Dumb Ray situation that is affecting the students of the school, and since Giles is only there temporarily, she just says that, well, if she needs to protect Blue, then she'll just do it the old-fashioned way and make her a vampire. Giles is like, oh no, 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 we don't. We're not gonna go turning little girls into vampires. And Roux is like, bitch, watch me, I'ma do this. And so, like, all this hullabaloo goes down, they start fighting and throwing shit at each other, and the mirror that Mrs. Vega had gifted to Giles to, like, protect him or what the heck ever, like, I don't understand what the fuck it means, it kind of, like, cracks, and it looks like it creates this explosion along with the other chemicals that are being thrown around in the chemistry lab. It's weird. So Roux runs away, Giles catches up with her in the cafeteria, she goes to grab Blue so that she can drag her off and make her into a vampire to protect her. Giles is like, oh heck no, but then she sicks the Sheffield twins, like the slaves that were bound to her, on Giles. She has the Sheffield twins lock Giles up in like this broom closet or what the heck ever, and she says, protect this girl. And she's like, sorry Giles, but I gotta do this, I'll take care of the demon. I can't get you being in my way. So because Rupert in his former life was the last thing that Seed touched before Rupert banished him to death, he is connected physically to Rupert. And it would appear that because Rupert was resurrected, it allowed for Seed to also return into the world, which makes sense-ish. And so Giles uses his connection to Seed to find out where he is, and then he calls up Dawn to open a portal to send him to where he needs to be. So Rupert shows up, he confronts Seed, Seed is like, okay, I'm glad you want to join me. Giles is like, oh no, no, I don't want to join you. And Seed's like, fuck you, bye, he throws him off the bridge. So Roux catches him in the nick of time, and she's like, hang out here, I'm gonna go kill this demon. And Giles is like, no, come back, girl. So Roux does not like Seed because Seed got Blue into trouble with this whole situation with the brain drain, etc. She takes this electrical cord and she messes up his machine and then she wraps him up with it, and it's bad. She's like, fuck you, this is for Blue. So Roux gets herself all entwined with Seed's like tentacles or whatever, and she electrocutes herself and Seed with this electrical wire so that when she dies, it'll be a permanent death. And that means that Seed, since Seed is like connected to her, will never be able to return to our world because her death will be like a final death, like a true death, okay? And so she's like, oh, it's a suicide mission and I love you, Giles, but I gotta do this so that you can live your life. So this is where we pick up right where we started in issue one with Giles jumping off the bridge, okay? And so Giles dives off the bridge to save Roux, and while he is in the water, he creates this like space for them to be able to like breathe and speak to one another down underwater, okay? And basically she's like, oh no, you have to let me die so that the demon can't come back, and you know, being dead is like not a great way to live. So Giles lets her die, and he puts his little tombstone down underwater for her, and he's super sad, but, you know, it was the right thing to do, and, you know, she'll still live in his heart. So then we see the aftermath, and, like, all the students aren't being, like, Dumbrella, Dumbray, brain-drained anymore, and, like, the school's getting back together. The principal, who allowed for these investors to come in, seemingly to help Seed with his whole brain-drain situation, she leaves, and we see that Addison has actually, like, lost some weight since he's not all brain-drained anymore, and he actually has students that are engaged and wanting to learn again, which is, you know, great. Rupert is still kind of looking after Blue, but he sees that she's gonna be just fine, she can take care of herself, and she's gonna be all well and good. Yay! And so then at the end, we have Giles' inner monologue narrating about Roux and how she's timeless and she's innocent, but not really because she stole his heart. And we see her tombstone or whatever down there, but it has all these numbers on it, but I couldn't tell you what the numbers mean. And that's how we end Giles season 11. Okay, so I wasn't going to do the whole recap part of this because I thought it was a waste of my goddamn time and yours, because, hello, the best thing that I can say about Giles season 11 is that it's a fuck ton shorter than Angel season 11, which was a bunch of bullshit, and this was not much better. You know, issue number 3, Oh my gosh. Issue number 3 is the only, like, I would say, good issue of this entire 4-issue run. Which is not great, Dark Horse, not great, Buffy writers, not great, Joss Whedon and Erica Alexander. Like, it's really not great. It's not great when you have 4 issues and only one of them is, like, objectively good. Like, it's good. And this whole story is just a bunch of bullshit. And, like, here, the thing is, issue number 3 was very much all character. It was just about Roux and understanding where she's coming from, what she's about, who she is, and why she, like, has come to be this, like, special vampire, okay? And it's all character, but then we get back in issue number 4, and it's like, oh crap, we gotta get to the plot, because the plot has to be wrapped up. Let's wrap this up, we gotta go. And what? Like, what did we accomplish here? Yeah, somebody on Twitter was like, I don't understand the plot, and that's the only reason I did the recap portion. It's so dumb. I don't know how to care about the relationship between Giles and Roux. Again, in the last issue, I really liked it because they finally got to the point where I understood, like, what the what was. And somebody was asking me in the last issue, does Roux have a soul? We don't know. We don't know why Roux has, like, blue flaming hair. We don't know why Roux gets these tattoos, or not quite tattoos, glowing all over her skin. We don't know why she feels so connected to Blue. These things are never explained. You could kind of, like, headcanon it that she sees Blue as being as vulnerable as she was in her human life, but there's no textual evidence to that point. It's all just kind of like, figure it out, girl. And I'm not about that. Like, I understand I like to be challenged and I like to kind of come to my own conclusions about things. Like, I don't want to be, you know, just like spoon-fed every idea that's going into this. But at the same time, you have to tell people what you're doing. And, like, I don't understand. Like, at the end, we've got the Sheffield twins. What's gonna happen to them? It looks like they're out in broad daylight. Are they just immortal or are they vampires? I don't know. Why does Roux care so much about Blue? Is there anything special about her, or does she just remind her of herself? I don't know. And the story won't tell you. What else? Giles, why does he care so much about Roux? Is it just because he's a horny teenager, or is there something deeper going on there? I don't know. And you know what? I feel like this whole brain drain situation is super convoluted. We don't need that. All we need is Seed possessing people at the high school, and you can have a much more concise story where we can really deal with the characters. Mrs. Vega, what was her point? In this issue, she's like, everybody repented, and that's why everybody's good. So what good was the mirror? What good was Mrs. Vega? She has no point in this story. It is ridiculous. It's re-damn-dickulous is what it is. And speaking of re-damn-dickulous, first of all, the Buffy mythology is kind of like, what are we doing with vampires and breath? Because all the time, you'll see Spike and Angel and other vampires, like, gasping for breath, and they're breathing heavy, and, like, when they're exerted, they're super breathing. And some people have argued that it's just a reflex, but after about, 200 years, you would, like, lose that reflex. And so we've been told from season 1 that vampires don't actually breathe, or they don't have to breathe, okay? And so they can probably produce breath, but it's not necessary for them. And yet, in this issue, when Roux is, like, down in the water, she's thinking, I can't breathe. What? How does any of this work? And then, down in the water, sure, she's been burned by electricity, but she didn't dust out. She didn't, like, super, like, vamp dust because of some electrical burns or what the heck ever. And so, why did she die? How did she die? They don't drown. She was just burnt. She wasn't, like, on fire. It's so dumb. It doesn't make any goddamn sense. It's just a bunch of stuff that doesn't take you anywhere. It doesn't make me feel anything. I don't care about the fact that Giles lost his new girlfriend because we had, like, 2.5 to get to know her, and then, like, whoop-de-doo, she up and kills herself. And I just, I don't know how to care about anything that's going on here. It is very Angel Season 11. I will say that it's much more concise than Angel Season 11, but at the same time, Angel Season 11 was pretty much just like, wow, time travel, nothing fucking matters. This goes out of its way to make you think that something here is going to matter, and it really fucking doesn't. It doesn't. It's dumb. Oh my gosh. I'm so disappointed with this because the first issue, I was like, eh, what are we doing? And the second issue, I was like, eh, what are we doing? And then the third issue, I was like, oh, I like what we're doing. And then the fourth issue was like, oh, we're not doing it anymore. But just do it all. Do it all. Get rid of it. It's in the story. And it jumps and it jumps and it jumps and it jumps. We don't need the seed and the brain drain situation. It's so convoluted. I don't know how people just picking this book up are understanding it, because I'm telling you, man, it took me a minute to like really figure out what all this is about. And again, like, I don't really know what it's about. Like, as far as the story, like, I get the plot, but I don't know what the story is actually about. Young love? Sacrifice? Sure. Young love and sacrifice, but, meh. Kind of weak sauce. It's not... The execution of this book is poor. It is poor. And I just don't like it. Let me look through this book a little bit. Well, let me look through my shots here. There's just nothing compelling. Again, I don't know how to care. I don't know why I should care. Again, I thought that there was going to be something super special about Blue. And even if there wasn't something super special about Blue, they could have had Roux say, there's nothing special about her. I just relate to her. I feel like I could have been her, or she could have been me. Say that. Don't leave it up to me to infer. And again, like, I don't want, like, reality spoon-fed to me, but at the same time, like, you need to give me a reason to care, or not care. Like, I'm over here not caring because I don't have a reason to, not because I have a reason not to care. You know what I mean? Does that make sense? I hope so, because this fucking book doesn't. I mean, it kind of makes sense, but it's all just filler. I really hope that this isn't the story that they planned to put out when Joss initially talked about putting this out. And I don't know how much of this is actually Joss. I really don't. I think he said, here's an outline of what I would like to do. Erica, you go in and actually write it. I don't like this. It was so disappointing. I went to dinner last night. I had already recorded, and then I went to dinner, and then I got home to edit, and I was like, I can't deal with this right now. And so I'm re-recording today, and I actually have to go to work tonight, which is random, but it's not very good, you guys. Again, we don't know how in cahoots frickin' the principal Boak was with Seed, or whether it was just like coincidence or what the heck ever. Like, I don't know how much longer I can talk about this, you guys. It's such a bad book. It's so dumb. I don't care. It's so dumb. So dumb. And like, we spend two pages with Giles and Addison in which they're basically trying to, like, at the last minute, get you plugged into the fact that, hey, by the way, Seed's still out there, and this is how we're gonna undo the thing, and by the way, I'm still possessed by Seed. It's all just very exposition-y, and we don't need any of that. We don't need this brain drain machine. We don't need this sky beam situation. Just, if you want to go back to high school, keep it small. Keep it in high school. Why go back to high school if we need these great, big, larger-than-life things when we could really just have a small, character-driven story that has nothing to do with the outside world, like, outside of high school? Like, keep it in high school. There's a demon possessing students, get to the bottom of it, oh crap, there's also a vampire girl, what's she about? Instead, we have way too much extra. There's so much extra fat here, you could have cut it out and done three issues. You really could have done this in three issues. Or you could take your time and do it in eight. But you can't just rush through it, give me one good issue, and then clip it off at the end. It's bad. It's really bad. And it's very un-Buffy. like, say what you will about Buffy season 11, they swung for the fences, I don't think they knocked it out of the park, but they were trying something, and here, I don't know what they were trying. It's all over the place, the themes are everywhere, the plot is so much extra, and it's dissatisfying at the end because you don't really know what's driving any of these characters. I don't know why I should care about Roux, and sadly, I don't know why I should care about Giles. His feelings in this are so random. And I get it, he's a teenager. Like, teenagers have random feelings, but they still have a sense of self and a sense of identity that I don't think any of the characters here truly have. It's just, whatever I'm doing is for the convenience of the plot, and I can't get on board with that. It's so dumb. Oh god, it's so dumb. But anyway, Planet Earth, I can't talk about this anymore. It's like, punchline, it's dumb, huh? So let me know what you thought of Giles, season 11, issue number 4, the conclusion, Girl Blue, part 4, in the comment section down below. I'm Preston L. Young, and you can come right back here to the Buffyngton Post anytime for Buffy the Vampire Slayer reviews. Buffy season 12, number 1, another 4-issue mini, will be out on June 20th. I said January in my original edit because my brain doesn't work anymore because this Giles comic actually brain-drained me. And then we'll be right here rocking out these crooked-ass teeth with a recap and review for that. I actually have a lot of stuff to do before we get there because I need to get back to season 10 and, like, finish all of my review for that because I don't have, like, the first 5, I think, issues of Buffy reviewed from season 10, as well as Angel and Faith season 10. And so I've got a lot to do, so look for all of that coming up before June 20th when Buffy season 12 hits. I've also got Angel and Faith reviews, Buffyverse discussions on the other Slayers, and more. I will get back to my Westworld reviews when I care enough to get back. But yeah, that's pretty much all I've got for you today, Planet Earth. I hope you're having a great 2018 so far, everybody. Have a great day today, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Terrified of all things, frightened of the dark. I am. You are taller than a mountain, deeper than the sea.
Okay, Planet Earth, so I don't know if any of you noticed how I kind of geeked out when I said Dumb Ray in my previously on, but it's actually a throwback to my real life because I used to work with this woman who was like dumber than an air conditioner. She's the dumbest person I've ever met, and so I came up with this idea that she was actually so dumb that she would affect the people around her. It was like her dumbness radiated around her and it created this dumbrella, and if you got caught in the dumbrella of dumb energy, then you would become dumb too. And she could focus this dumbrella energy into a dumb ray so that she could use it individually, like the Scarlet Witch, okay? And so the whole idea of the dumb ray and the dumbrella, I don't know why it didn't occur to me until this issue, but it totally did, and I've just been like laughing. I could have had this dumbrella dumb ray joke the whole time. I just missed it, but yeah, it's fine. And yeah. Do you know anybody who's dumber than an air conditioner?